Despite headwinds from the pandemic and considerable contraction in corporate banking revenue pools in Asia Pacific, Deutsche Bank achieved a 6% year-on-year growth in revenue. Cash management deposits increased by 12% as a result of sharp strategic changes matched by continued service excellence and continual enhancement of products and services to meet real-time treasury needs. Critical to the bank's performance was the exceptional and time-critical response with new and existing digital solutions such as DocuSign, e-banking, and FX for Cash, as well as the development of automated processes such as Gen Connect and operating guidelines to protect customers against operational risk. The bank continues to strengthen its global transaction franchise as the corporate bank contributes 21% to the total bank income. The bank has built a significant presence in the region, backed by its ability to implement deals in the key Asia-Pacific markets of Australia, China, India, Thailand, Singapore, Vietnam, and more, covering FX, liquidity, virtual accounts, and real-time payments. For these successes, Deutsche Bank was awarded the Best International Transaction Bank in Asia-Pacific in 2021 by the Asian Banker.
Hi, Chintan. Good to see you again since the virtual award some time ago. And congratulations to Deutsche Bank for being named the best transaction bank in Asia Pacific. What were the key drivers for the global cash management business sustained business performance amidst COVID-19 uncertainty and business disruption?
Thank you, Asian Banker, in acknowledging Deutsche Bank as the best transaction bank in APAC. COVID-19 has been a pretty significant year, right? As you could see. It transformed the digital journey for our corporate clients much faster than what we all perceived it to be at the beginning. At Deutsche Bank, we did continued our journey on significant investments. We helped our clients not only from onboarding of our clients digitally through e-signatures to also enabling our clients to a fully next-gen client access channels automation through digital service manager, cash manager next-gen, as well as liquidity portals. So it's been a pretty remarkable year for us in terms of how we have moved with our clients in enabling them not only from a business continuity at the beginning of COVID-19 to a full digital transformation over the last now almost 18 months. In APAC, which is highly exchange-controlled regulated markets, we also introduced a new solution called Gem Connect. Under this solution, we offer an integrated liquidity, payments, and FX workflow solutions that enables our clients to move money out of restricted markets in APAC in a fully automated manner, particularly in APAC, which has exchange-controlled regulations. To connect the dot between all of these three work streams for our clients was extremely efficient.
Amid the pandemic, businesses have pivoted to digital transactions. How is Deutsche Bank helping your customers make that transition?
Again, the stay-at-home economy really flourished with e-commerce companies and fintech companies expanding exponentially. At Deutsche Bank, we've always invested in our technology platforms through APIs and instant payments and other solutions. When you look at all of the solutions, plus the Gem Connect offering that I mentioned, coupled with a very strong understanding of the entire risk management and governance that we need to put in place to help our clients in this economy, was the cornerstone of our offering. We did that with large gamut of our clients, which are global clients coming into APAC or an Asian client going global through this period. And we've been able to stitch the solutions between technology and risk management and help these clients scale up as they expand globally.
Deutsche Bank's revenues from trade finance increased 15%, further buoyed by strict cost controls via trade automation and digitalization initiatives, as well as focus on capturing flows between strategic trade corridors in Asia Pacific. With high demand for supply chain financing and risk mitigation, the bank ensured continuous supply of liquidity to keep businesses going. It offered various dynamic discounting programs to customers with strong balance sheets in order to help suppliers gain access to liquidity in an efficient and inexpensive manner. It launched a slew of digital initiatives targeting the entire trade ecosystem. It accelerated the implementation of e-signatures to replace wet signatures, leveraged data to implement a next-generation compliance analytics toolset, including the application of name entity recognition technology to automate regulatory and compliance checks. It used intelligent document recognition to extract, classify, and convert paper to data while achieving trade process efficiencies. For these successes, Deutsche Bank was awarded the Best International Trade Finance Bank in Asia Pacific in 2021 by the Asian Banker.
Atul, what were some of the most pressing challenges and issues that the trade business community face, and how is Deutsche Bank helping to mitigate those challenges?
Well, firstly, thank you for the opportunity to speak to you. It's wonderful to see you. I think in regards to your question, the trade industry has really had to work through five key themes over the past 18 months. The first is global supply chain disruption. Second is geopolitical tension. The third is increased fraud. The fourth is restrictive access to credit. And the fifth is a call on corporates from society to operate with a clearer social and environmental purpose. And we thread the needle on these themes with success. So if you look at our business across trade finance and lending in Asia Pacific, in 2020, we grew our revenue double digit for the third consecutive year. So I get the question a lot, how did we do that? And simply put, we stuck by our clients, we delivered the best of our global network to them, even while most of us were operating from home. We developed thoughtful solutions to their most complex and structured financing needs. And we continue to invest in digitization and our people, who really remain at the heart of what sets our franchise apart. So in short, five themes that we've had to work through, tremendous success at working through them. And a lot of it just comes back to doing what we've always done, which is investing in our people, both in service and in structuring, and in sticking by our clients in the context of global network and in the context of new ideas.
As a global trade finance bank with significant corporate customer base and presence in Asia, how are you leveraging the technology and data to digitize supply chain financing in the region?
And this is such an important question and such a tricky question, and one that is tricky because we have to start with being very honest, which is trade is a stubbornly manual business. And I'm convinced that within the next 5 years, the industry will go through the digital nirvana that is required. And when it does, that the business and the way it's prosecuted will be completely unrecognizable, which is both extremely exciting and extremely scary for a practitioner in this business. Mm. And here, there are really three things I would call out. The first is looking in the mirror, right? We need to start with ourselves. We need to evolve our own Mesozoic processes to be more digitally resilient, particularly around operational process and transaction controls. Secondly, leveraging our leadership position across various industry bodies and associations to advocate change, and also working with our peer banks and fintechs to test new ideas like market standard APIs for trade. Mm-hmm. And lastly, it's really showing our clients a new way forward, whether that's real-time data analytics for their financial supply chain offering, whether that's an automated platform for bank guarantees, or whether that's completely new financing models. So we started a new pillar within our global business 2 years back, referred to as Asset as a Service, which was in response to the emergence of pay-per-use business models.
As a prominent thought leader in global cash clearing and institutional payments business space, Deutsche Bank continues to adopt high standards of global transparency, visibility, and safety for processing all commercial and treasury payments on SWIFT GPI rails. Its Asia Accelerator service and artificial intelligence capabilities, coupled with high book transfer ratios and correspondent reach, ensure timely payment flows to its customers on a priority basis to their final beneficiaries. The bank digitized and improved both liquidity FX management through its Gem Connect platform, which links liquidity management strategy with FX execution. For these successes, Deutsche Bank was awarded the Best Euro Clearing Bank in Asia Pacific in 2021 by the Asian Banker.
Jan, we are into the second year of the pandemic. What were some of the key challenges and issues that persisted for your FI and institutional clients? And what measures are you taking to leverage your wider correspondent banking reach?
Well, thank you, Boonping, for having me. As a commercial bank, We maintain corporate and retail sector liquidity, and we also provide government support. Operational resilience is something that was mostly demanded and highly appreciated by our customers. It's really very much about BAU. We can operate the same way we did before, during, and perhaps after the pandemic. But the impact it had to us is not something that hit us unprepared or out of the left field. If I want to pinpoint a date, I'll probably go back 20 years and the tragic event of 9/11. Everything prior 9/11 was much more paper-based and less automated. And it made us rethink, how do we have to set up ourselves? When the pandemic hit, we had basically overnight 70,000 people working from home, full remote access, able to support our customers 24/7, follow the sun model, and no limitations on system access. They needed a strong backbone, a backbone as Deutsche Bank, to support them not only with staff, with the products, with the services, and let me also mention full facilities. So we didn't cut any of our facilities, whether it's credit facilities or any other services to our customers. So we could be there when our customers needed us. One example I want to mention here is a payment for urgently needed medical supply. It was a payment between two countries. So here we as Deutsche Bank were able to bridge the gap and facilitate this payment and basically handhold this payment for the two organizations and build that in the middle level of trust between those. The next day, the plane could leave the airport and the medical supplies arrived the next day, urgently needed with ventilators, with masks, etc. The other thing what I would want to mention, a few developments that happened through this pandemic and got accelerated through the pandemic. Mm-hmm. One very paper-based heavy thing that we are working on is probably KYC. Here we were able to go much more digital, to have electronic documents instead of the physical ones being couriered. And also with our DocuSign, we were able to move from red signatures to electronic signatures. So that was a big kind of improvement for our customers. Mm. Lastly, I have to mention something that was there prior to the pandemic, but again got accelerated through the pandemic, is self-servicing. So that was something with our DB Direct Internet platform, we were able to enhance, accelerate, and roll out even further to our customers.
The volatility in markets necessitate support for your institutional customers. Despite continued macroeconomic challenges, headwinds, how do you see the future outlook in the clearing space, and how is the bank managing evolving client needs?
I see two major developments that probably will have somewhat of a seismic shift for the industry itself. And the first thing I'll mention is probably something that we announced in 2019 at the beginning of the pandemic, and that is our partnership with Google. We have launched 20 plus application landing zones, as we call them. These application landing zones are mostly API connected for internal developed as well as third-party developed value-added services. You will see more and more of those being added. So our Google partnership will move our operating platform to the next level. And the other thing I would add on to that is an industry initiative that again is not unique to Deutsche Bank. This ISO, it's simply a format change between or from MT to MX. But this simple format change will have an array of impact. All of them are upgrading to this new MX format. And this MX format will have more information and more structured information. And this aspect alone will basically then help to fix many, I want to say, of the maybe regulatory required pain points that hinder the progress of correspondent banking. And I think in combination with many of the industry players upgrading their platform to a cloud-based, nimble, much more agile system, this will vastly improve what you're seeing today. Now, we're going to go live with ISO as Deutsche Bank in 2022. So we're there ourselves live, fully supporting the new format, but we will work with our customers up to 2025 where we support both.